Dr. David Hu, a mechanical engineer at Georgia Tech, is interested in snake locomotion, how they slither on smooth surfaces.
These snakes end up slithering in place, kind of like on a snake treadmill.
What happens when you put them in a sock?
Yes, it was hand-knit. We sell them in sizes long, extra long, and extra, extra long.
Putting them on jello, which, believe it or not,
this is sort of a classical biology technique.
And the goal is to mathematically describe slithering, which is technically defined as
a lateral undulation. There it just sends a traveling wave down its body.
Over 50 years ago, biologists showed that snakes propel themselves by pushing against branches and rocks on the ground.
Like you would if you were, say, on roller skates and you're going to go between buildings, you'd use your hands to push against the side of the buildings.
That explains slithering on rough terrain, but
they couldn't explain how snakes moved on deserts, hard rock, flat surfaces.
So after having snakes slither up inclines and slide down planes, Hu and his colleagues discovered something about snake scales.
Well, what we found was that what was previously thought to be going on in the macro scale, that is the snake pushing with the sides of its body against large objects, is actually going on the micro scale.
Instead of the snake's body pushing off of big things, like tree trunks, its scales are pushing off of tiny things, like small bumps in the ground, and this gives the snake traction. And that's why on man-made bumpless surfaces, like this one, the snakes don't go anywhere.
The fact that they can't move on these smooth surfaces tells you that these scales actually have an effect.
And the arrangement of the scales, they're sort of like shingles, is key because they provide more friction in certain directions. Think of petting a dog. It takes more force to go against the direction of the fur. And the jacket experiment shows this.
By putting the snake jacket on, you're sort of taking away the effect of the scales. Because friction still exists everywhere. It's just now equal in all directions.
But even after all these factors were accounted for in the model, something didn't add up.
We were really surprised that the actual snakes were traveling 35% faster than we predicted.
The variable that was missing in the model is that snakes don't slither flat on the ground. Look at this.
It'll lift the curved parts, and it'll keep the middle of the S on the ground.
This allows the snake to decrease friction on the parts of the body that are working against the motion and put more weight into the areas that are propelling the snake along. And it doesn't have to lift itself much.
Snake lifts its body a single molecule above the ground, it'll have this great enhancement in speed and efficiency. So it's something that's not visible. It's something we had to really see with our mathematical model.
And also with jello.
Oh yeah, that's right. Jello has this nice property that if you shine polarized light through it and view it through another polarizing filter, the jello will tend to light up in areas that you're pressing down with the most.
Who would have thought slithering was so complicated?
You think snake locomotion would be easy because all you are is this sort of living string, all you do is bend. But they really have fine-tuned the art of slithering.
Hu and his colleagues published their findings in the proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences this week. For Science Friday, I'm Flora Lichtman.